There are activation. Somebody say activation.
Activation.
For example, I told you before that the law, the constitution, if the lawmakers come together and there is a new, there is something in the constitution. Now, the laws, those things on their own is not enough. Laws don't enforce itself. That's why they create different agencies. There are law enforcement agencies. Now, there are scriptures that will never come into manifestation in your life until you enforce them. They are enforced. That's what Jesus said. When he took the scroll of the book of Isaiah given to him in the temple, when he was done reading, part of it says, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, how he has anointed me to preach the good news, the acceptable year, to heal the brokenhearted, to open the eyes of the blind, to do this and to do that." Then he said, "But up till now, this thing has not been activated." He said, "From today, this thing shall come into divine activation." So he knew that something needed to be activated, but the thing was not activated. The thing was activated in River Jordan when John the Baptist baptized him. So he knew about it, that this thing needs to be activated, but it wasn't activated for 30 years until he came to River Jordan. In River Jordan, he said it's a necessity to go through this process so that this thing can be activated. And the Bible said it came to pass that when John the Baptist baptized him, that heaven was open and the Spirit of Elohim descended upon him like a dove. And after that, voice came from heaven and said, "Lord, behold my beloved son, whom I am well pleased. Listen to him. Hear him." From that moment, it was activated. So what activates the abundance life is the Spirit of God. How do you get the Spirit of God to activate it? That's what we have been dealing with all this while. Because there are things God expects you to do on your own. Nobody will enforce it for you. You will enforce it by yourself, by the Spirit of God.